for that is something called estro support. And at her body weight, she's probably going to need to take about two times per day, about six altogether. And when you come back to the pH paper, as long as she's got good, strong kidney, no leg swelling or anything, she can go on something called pH Trio and use it to force the pH into the ideal range. Sometimes this is really easy, Ray. Sometimes it's really hard. Sometimes we have to support the parathyroid, the kidney. We've got a bad tooth. We've got something else that's just using up all the minerals. And hopefully she can go on pH Trio and the pH will quickly come into range. If not, you'll give a buzz to the order line. They'll tell you the name of a QRA person right there in Houston. They can test her, find out if she's got a dead tooth, a gum issue, a leaking restoration, whatever the heck it is that is sucking off and using up the minerals, and get that squared away, and then she'll have control of the pH. When you have control of these two things, I think you're going to love what goes on in the body. And if she's 190 and that's a little overweight, I would urge you to get a copy of the Biofield Diet. You call the order line, and I would recommend that you and she both go on it. It's very easy diet, but it's very profound. I've used it on thousands of people, and I just want everybody on earth to know how to eat and be able to enjoy this life. Okay?
Gotcha. Perfect.
Take care.
Will do. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome, Bob. This is Dr. Bob Marshall, PhD. This is Healthline Live. Let's go to Jennifer in Burbank, California. And she's concerned about the health of her thyroid. Are you there, Jennifer?
I am.
And
hi.
How old a woman are you, and how much do you weigh?
I'm 29 years old, and I weigh 200 pounds.
Okay. Well, the first thing that you want to know is to have the best health for your thyroid. Your thyroid needs iodine, okay? And we need to be sure that we're getting enough. And usually in our food, unless you eat a lot of fish, you're not going to be getting enough iodine. And this could be the problem. Now, we've learned a lot from the Japanese in terms of the health of the breasts and the uterus, also depending on good levels of iodine. And here you may want to go on something like XenoX. And this guy, you can take maybe in the beginning, maybe 9 capsules at your main protein meal, preferably lunch, and you would do that for about 2 to 3 months, and then you would cut down to 3 at that meal, and that will kind of assure you that you've got good vegetable, sea vegetable, live source iodine for the thyroid, the breasts, and the uterus. Now, for many people, this is not enough. There may be an immune issue at your thyroid, and you would need to see someone to figure out what nutrients you would need to promote best health. You're in luck. You're in Burbank. You're very close to our Santa Monica clinic, and I know they can get to the bottom of it no matter what's going on. And sadly, the thyroid has been shown energetically to be dependent on parathyroid function. A healthy parathyroid, which then may allow the thyroid to uptake iodine so you can function at your very best. If that's not enough, then give a buzz to the Santa Monica Clinic, and that phone number is area code 310-320-1132. All right?
I did buy your thyroid support, the
okay.
Quantum thyroid.
Well, remember, there's no iodine in that. So that's designed to be taken with immune support, such as hyssop or some form of immune support. But first we have to be sure the parathyroid is not blocking you. And this would be a fairly inexpensive test visit at the clinic to figure out what you need and how much. But I would do these couple things I've suggested. If it's not to your liking, then give a buzz to the clinic, because then you know you're going to get your money's worth. All right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you for your call. Bye now.
Thank you.
All right. You guys that are on the line, stay right there. We'll catch you off the air. We're almost out of time. Don't miss today's really great special. our Quantum Noni. This is nutrition that really works, smells, tastes good. It promotes healthy mood, and of course it promotes the production of serotonin, which is what does that. And at the same time, it helps promote best digestion and immune support. It's the cleanest, best product I've been able to find. You'll buy one, get the second one 50% off. Do remember, though, if there are issues with mood, there may also be issues with B vitamin metabolism. And this happens to us if we drink a lot of alcohol, get food poisoning, or eat a lot of sugar, or have extreme stress. So if we have any of those, you may want to also jump on Max Stress B. This is nutrition that really works. The two together may be just what you need to have the best possible mood and get you back to on track feeling great. Just give a buzz to our order line, 800-370-3447. That body is your greatest treasure. Get help, get and take care of it beautifully. Bye for now.
You've been listening to Dr. Bob Marshall, Ph.D., on Healthline Live. To find out more about these specials or any of our other great products, call 1-800-370-3447. That's 1-800-370-3447. Dr. Marshall's comments have not been evaluated by the FDA and are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Have a healthy and radiant day.
Dodgers infielder Justin Turner is on Open Season this Thursday on KCAA, and we'll talk Father's Day and football with Texans lineman Devin Still. I'm Larry Burnett. Tune in Thursday at 3:05 p.m. for Open Season on AM 1050, FM 106.5.
If you can't decide what to get Dad for Father's Day, now you don't have to. The Home Depot has four great tools and one great gift. The Ryobi One Plus Lithium Ion Super Combo Kit, now just $129. Its powerful lithium-ion battery also works in over 70 other tools. So that was the easy part. Now, go pick out a card. The Ryobi 4-Piece Super Combo Kit, just $129. Father's Day savings now at the Home Depot. More saving, more doing. Valid through June 22nd, U.S. only.
You're listening to KCAA, Loma Linda, California. The best station in the nation.
I'm Tom Busby, CNBC Radio. Wall Street closing higher for a change today, snapping a streak of 5 days in a row of losses as investors staged a late-day surge in stock buying despite worries about next week's vote on whether Britain would remain a member of the European Union. The Dow today 93 points higher, the Nasdaq up 10. Late earnings from weapons maker Smith & Wesson better than expected. The company also expects blowout sales. Oracle earnings also better than forecast, and its booming cloud computing unit helped offset weakness in software sales. Cosmetics giant Revlon is buying rival Elizabeth Arden for $870 million cash. That's a 50% premium to the closing price today. And Americans paid more for gasoline, healthcare, and housing in May, with rent and mortgage costs increasing by the most in 9 years. Overall, though, consumer prices up just a modest 0.2% last month, helped by a dip in the price of food. Tom Busby, CNBC.
KCAA.
Inland Body and Paint is a family-owned and operated fleet collision and repair shop that's proud to live in and help our community. Bring your heavy-duty trucks and or equipment to their Fleet Collision and Paint Center in Fontana for expert collision repair services. With 35 years of experience, you're sure to receive quality workmanship at an excellent price from Inland Body and Paint Center. From fiberglass repairs to quality painting, they'll take care of your truck and equipment from top to bottom in their new 64-foot spray booth. By the way, Inland Body and Paint of Fontana repaired and repainted the KCAA truck, and they can do the same job for your car, truck, or heavy-duty equipment. Inland Body and Paint, dedicated to the community and to your satisfaction. Call them today to learn what they can do for you. You can find Inland Body and Paint on Valencia in Fontana. Call them at 909-434-0466 or online at inlandbodyandpaint.com.
Mm-hmm.
Good afternoon. Open season is straight ahead right here on the station that leaves no listener behind. Right now, a peek at what's going on in the world nationally and locally right here on KCAA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM. President Obama and Vice President Biden are at the Orlando Amway Center for a private meeting with the families of the victims of Sunday's massacre. Gunman Omar Mateen opened fire in a gay nightclub, killing 49 people. He was later killed by police. White House spokesman Josh Earnest says the president will stand in solidarity with the community as they embark on their recovery. And the head of the CIA is warning about the potential for more attacks like Sunday's massacre at the nightclub. John Brennan told the Senate Intelligence Committee today that success against ISIS by the U.S.-led military coalition in Iraq and Syria will probably result in more attacks. Brennan said ISIS has a large group of Western fighters who are capable of reaching all points of the globe. Kind of scary. And here at home, a body exhumed from a graveside on the Saboba Indian Reservation has been identified as that of a man missing for nearly a month. Sheriff's homicide detectives say that Jerome Salgado, 37, of San Jacinto, had suffered traumatic injuries and his death is being investigated as a homicide. Salgado was last seen May 20th in the Hemet area. He was reported missing 2 days later, finding the gravesite in a remote area of the reservation on Indian Creek Trek Trail. It was reported last Sunday. Inland Empire weather, we are on a warming trend, highs reaching the 90s by Saturdays. By Sunday, we're going to be into the 100s, triple digits for Sunday and Monday, high of 110. Looking at Sunday, 106, Saturday, 94, 87 Friday, and 82 today. Currently, we're at 81 degrees here in San Bernardino. Checking out your drive, a lot of stuff going on out there, a lot of stop and go. Through Fontana, stop and go, 15 northbound between Sierra and the 215. In Moreno Valley, stop and go, 215 between Cactus and Alessandro. Southbound side is slow and go from Mount Vernon to MLK. Also in Corona, stop and go, 15 northbound between Magnolia and the 91 freeway. In Moreno Valley, stop and go, 60 westbound between Day Street and the 215. And through Chino, stop and go, 60 eastbound between Ramona and Central Avenue. And also in Chino, the 10 eastbound is a bit slow in pockets from the 57 to Cherry Avenue. And that is very latest with news, weather, and traffic on the station that leaves no listener behind, KCAA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM.
Woohoo! It's time for Open Season with award-winning sportscaster Larry Burnett. Open Season, where they tackle issues, drop gloves, and swing for the fences. Hey, let's quit wasting time and dive right in to Open Season.
Open Season is on the air, in the air, and almost everywhere. Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Sports Fan, and all ships at sea. Dodgers infielder Justin Turner and his hair and his beard, they're all on the show today.
I honestly couldn't even tell you the last time I put a razor on my face, so the beard's definitely not going anywhere. And my hair, you know, it gets shortened here and there, but, you know, it always ends up being pretty long by the end.
Last night it was Kershaw with a K. That's Kershaw with a K as the Dodgers snag the snakes. In hoops, game 6 tonight for the Cavs and the Warriors in the NBA Finals. In hockey, the Penguins are trying on a new cup. Oh, my! And the Ducks have a new boss, same as the old boss. You'll hear from L.A. Rams quarterback Jared Goff. He's been working with the A-team in the OTA. In golf, the U.S. Open is officially open, but a bit wet at Oakmont. And we'll talk with Texans defensive lineman Devin Still. He's got a lot to celebrate this Father's Day after his daughter's battle with cancer.
With my daughter battling cancer, I had a chance of losing my daughter, but she was strong and she continued to fight. And this will actually be our first Father's Day with her out of the hospital, so I'm definitely looking forward to spending some time with her.
All that and a big bag of chips, which you can purchase for a nominal fee. It's open season, everybody, where our motto remains, if it's news in sports, it's news to us.
I'm Larry Burnett with Eric Geller. This is Open Season. Our phone number is 888-909-1050. We appreciate you tuning in. And as we always say at the top of the show, we are on the air, in the air, and almost everywhere. And where the heck are you, Eric?
I'm in Starbucks outside of USC. Getting
ready
for an
NFL. You have a
very
sultry voice right now.
Thank you very much. Well, you know, I don't want to be yelling in here.
Come on. What are they going to do, throw you out of a Starbucks?
Either that, you know, hey, it's summer school people, you know, they're paying a lot of money to go to school here, so I don't want to, like, do anything. There's a Rams event over at the Coliseum, and I thought I was going to be able to get in there and go live from the Coliseum, but they're not letting us in yet, so I had to run over this way. And so this is where I am, and nice background music for you and everything. Look at that.
It is. It's very very eclectic. And by the way, while you're there, could you order me a Java chip with a shot of peppermint, please?
Would you like extra whipped cream with that?
Oh, absolutely. I'm a whipped cream kind of guy. Let's get the NBA Finals Game 6 tonight. Golden State now leading that one 3-2. Everybody talking about Game 5. Draymond Green was suspended. How much of an impact did it have? I think it had a big impact. I think the fact that Andrew Bogut went out with the knee injury had a big impact as well tonight. But everybody talking about Draymond Green. What do you think about that situation?
You know, if you're going to kick people in the groin and you continually do it, I guess, or even accidentally sock someone in the groin, at some point, someone's got to, like, take a stand and say, you're done for a few. You can't do that. That's not part of the game, not part of the rules, although back in the 80s, they did that almost every play, whether it was playoffs or not. But I think the big thing was in the fourth quarter, the Warriors only scored 16 points, and with 8 minutes left in the game, I think they only scored 1 point. So the defense for Cleveland was very good. Obviously, LeBron and Kyrie Irving were amazing, but something happened. You know, you're going to live by the three-point shot, you're going to die by the three-point shot. So that's what happened in that fourth quarter, I think.
Well, and they had a lot of open looks, too, and then just didn't knock them down. You know, if they do, it's a whole different game. But, you know, you look at Kyrie with 40-plus points. You look at LeBron with 40-plus points. I'm still wondering when Kevin Love is going to show up to the party here, but that's a whole other story. But, you know,
he looks
LeBron
lost.
Also had a bunch of rebounds. He had a bunch of assists. I don't think he gets those rebounds if Draymond Green is in there. I don't think he gets those rebounds if Bogut is in there. So I think it definitely had an impact, and I don't think people realize how important Draymond Green is to what this team does defensively, offensively. He passes the ball exceptionally well. He's like a point power forward, if you will, handling the basketball. And on the defensive end, he's the guy who kind of reads what's going on offensively, decides whether to go over and double team and where the switch is and where do you help out and when do you not help out. And there were a lot of times I thought in Game 5 where Golden State just looked like they were lost defensively.
Well, if you listen to the post-game press conference from Steph Curry and Steve Kerr, they said that although Steph is the two-time league MVP, the MVP of the Warriors is Draymond Green because he helps make everything happen. He, like you said, he's the facilitator. So, yeah, they missed him big time. And I think when he's not in there, I think it has a lot to do with them missing those three-pointers in that fourth quarter because he wasn't there to help out, to be the physical force that they need because they're pretty much a finesse team without him in there.
Yeah, and to get those offensive rebounds as well to get the extra opportunities, the second chance points they didn't get. So Draymond Green was the big story in Game 5. He's back tonight for Game 6 in Cleveland, and we'll see what happens, what they can do without Andrew Bogut. Now, there's more than a few people, and I'm sure you've heard this, Eric, than a few people who have said, oh, the fix is in, the league wants it to go 7 games. You know, that's why they suspended Draymond Green. Well, I don't know if this adds any credence to it or not. Remember the referee Tim Donaghy, the guy who got convicted of fixing games as a ref? He came out the other day and says, you know, I think there's something a little fishy about Green getting suspended for game number 5. Here's what he said. I think when you look at the overt acts that Green has committed before, they were definitely more severe than this act. This would be the hitting of LeBron James. And he's going to end up with a flagrant foul and suspension because of it. In the past, I believe it was disregarded because the Warriors were down in the series. Now they're up in the series, so I think it's a situation where with that, it gives Cleveland a better chance of prolonging the series.
So this from Tim Donahue, who has, you know, fixed games in the past, but he's a former NBA ref, and he's not the only person out there thinking it this way.
Or he's just a bitter guy. You know, I don't know. I mean, you can't take anything away from Cleveland. They're an excellent basketball team. And, I mean, they have good players on there that know how to play well, and they know how to win a basketball game against anybody as well. It's just a question is if they can win four against the Warriors. I don't, you know, we talked about this last week, I think it was Howard Beck that was on the show. And I specifically asked him that question. And he said there's no way. And I tend to agree with that. I just think he's just bitter. You know, I just think it's a bitter pill that he's still swallowing, and he can't get rid of that taste.
I was trying to get some overtime on his 15 minutes of fame.
Exactly.
Distraction or not, I don't know, but the report is that J.R. Smith has now said that he's not going to re-sign with Cleveland right away. He's going to check into free agency, see what the options are out there. You know, more power to him, but is this the right time for this to come up for the Cleveland Cavaliers?
I don't think it matters. I mean, they probably expect him to do that. Look at what the Clippers players are doing, all those guys, Austin Rivers. Cole Aldridge, they're all going to test the free agent market. That doesn't mean that they're not going to come back. And he has every right to do that. I don't think they care about that. I think they're trying to figure out what to do with Kevin Love, because all he seems to do is stand in the corner behind the three-point line and just sit there and watch everything happen.
I don't see that guy busting his hump. I don't see him busting his hump with the urgency that this team is in right now. I don't see it.
You know what the problem is? I think he plays the same position basically as LeBron James. And if I were him, and I don't know, but I would just crash the boards and just play some defense, box out, get a rebound here and there, because that's what he's really good at. And maybe try to like open up a fast break, because he was really good at that at UCLA.
Yeah, he's good with the outlet pass.
So if you're not going to score, just crash the boards and help the team out that way. But I just think he's just lost somehow. I don't know. So, it's sad.
I think the timing is bad for Smith to come out with this comment. But anyway, we'll switch on to something different. Craig Sager is going to work for ESPN tonight. He's going to be on the sidelines for ESPN covering the game. Of course, he's worked for years and years and years for TNT. He's the guy with the wild sport coats and ties and everything else. He's been battling cancer. He's been in and out of treatment. I'm not sure what his prognosis is, but the guy has never worked an NBA Finals game because TNT has never had the rights to them, and they don't this year. But TNT and ESPN have worked it out so that he will work one of the sidelines tonight. Doris Burke will work the other on the ABC ESPN telecast. And I think it's a great move. I don't know what anybody thinks about him, if you care about him or whatever else, but, you know, there's some things in your life and in your career that you say, that's on your bucket list. And my guess is working the NBA Finals is on Sager's bucket list.
I think so. You know, when I first read that report, I just had a smile on my face because, you know, it's different call letters, but we're all trying to do the same thing, and they're all trying to do the same thing, and they're all on the same team, basically. So, and that was probably on his bucket list, and he's not doing well, apparently. So, he's strong enough to be able to do this, and I think it's great that ESPN, ABC, and TNT were able to do that.
Yeah, and more power to everybody involved, because a few years ago, it would have never happened. I mean, a few years ago, you know, TNT wouldn't let ESPN use their video until a game was over, and you can only use 2 minutes. You know, it's all changed radically, and I think for the good. All right, later on Open Season, you're going to hear from Rams quarterback Jared Goff. You'll also hear from Houston Texans defensive lineman Devin Still. And up next, we're going to talk Dodgers with Justin Turner. This guy's having some fun with the young guns like Peterson, Seager, and Thompson on this year's Dodger squad.
It's kind of carrying over into the clubhouse and on the field with them, and it's spreading out through the locker room. We're getting to know them. Not only as players, obviously, which they're doing outstanding on the field, but we're getting to know a lot more about them, you know, off the field, which has been a lot of fun.
If you're trying to prevent home foreclosure, you need a law firm with extensive experience representing clients in protecting their homes from foreclosure. The Goodman Law Firm is a nationwide team of mortgage mitigation attorneys that provides legal advice and expertise you can trust. Our nationwide network includes local of council foreclosure attorneys to represent you during the mortgage mitigation process. The Goodman firm has represented homeowners across the nation in resolving their troubled mortgages. We have the experience and the knowledge you can count on to best represent your interests. The banks have attorneys fighting to protect their interests, and so should you. Call the Goodman Law Firm at 888-800-6030. Take control of your mortgage situation today. Contact us at 888-800-6030 or through our website at arnoldgoodmanlaw.com.
Ever wonder how celebrities get their skin red carpet ready? Look no further than the Fire and Ice Facial from Is Clinical, available at Nina MD Beverly Hills. The Fire and Ice Facial is an amazing clinical treatment designed to rapidly and safely regenerate the skin, reducing fine lines and wrinkles for an envious glow, while smoothing and softening to achieve that ageless face. Excellent for all skin types and ages, Is Clinical's Fire and Ice Facial is a celebrity favorite and provides dramatic results with no downtime, peeling, or side effects. The Fire and Ice Facial is normally $215, but call 310-777-7511 now. Mention this ad and pay only $179. That's over $35 in savings just by mentioning this ad. Don't miss out on glowing and radiant skin from Is Clinical and Nina MD Beverly Hills. For more info, visit ninamd.com or call 310-777-7511. That's 310-777-7511. Ever wonder how celebrities get their skin red carpet ready? Look no further than the Fire and Ice Facial from Is Clinical, available at Nina MD Beverly Hills. The Fire and Ice Facial is an amazing clinical treatment designed to rapidly and safely regenerate the skin, reducing fine lines and wrinkles for an envious glow, while smoothing and softening to achieve that ageless face. Excellent for all skin types and ages, Is Clinical's Fire and Ice Facial is a celebrity favorite and provides dramatic results with no downtime, peeling, or side effects. The Fire and Ice Facial is normally $215, but call 310-777-7511 now. Mention this ad and pay only $179. That's over $35 in savings just by mentioning this ad. Don't miss out on glowing and radiant skin from Is Clinical and Nina MD Beverly Hills. For more info, visit ninamd.com or call 310-777-7511. That's 310-777-7511.
All right, back once again here on Open Season. Thanks for being with us, Larry Brand, along with Eric Giller. We got Di Rice back at the studio. The Dodgers got a nice win over Arizona last night. They won their last two games against the Diamondbacks and managed to finish up 3-3 on their road trip. On the season right now, they're three games above 500. So, you know, not too bad. And they'll open a seven-game homestand against Milwaukee and Washington starting tonight. Yesterday, it was Clayton Kershaw getting the win once again. He's now 10-1. He went 7 1/3 innings, gave up 5 hits, a couple of earned runs, 1 walk, 11 strikeouts. So on the season now, Eric, he's got 133 strikeouts and 7 walks that he's given up all year long.
Talk about a zone. Yeah, that's unheard of. He's amazing. Maybe the best. This is probably the best pitching year, his best year ever, and he's already won 2 Cy Young Awards, so we'll see if he can continue this.
Yeah. By the way, Eric is talking in muffled tones because he's trying to be polite at the Starbucks outside of Coliseum, where he'll be going in just a little bit to be part of a Rams program right there. So the Dodgers, when Kershaw starts, they're 13-1. When he doesn't, they're 21-31. Most valuable player, maybe? Could be.
Absolutely.
Kenley Jansen picked up a save last night. That's his 19th. Gives him 161 for his career, and that ties the Dodger record set by Eric Gagne.
They made a huge move, by the way. Remember that the big move this week was they signed Will Venable. I have no idea. You know,
Will Venable, he's okay. He's okay. I mean, he can help him in the outfield. He's a contact kind of a hitter. He played for Dave Roberts when Roberts was down in San Diego. He's bounced around, but this is kind of the MO for the front office now. You know, we're not bringing in the big names. We're bringing in guys that may have some mileage on them, may have some injuries, but it'll probably work cheap.
And Ethier's back soon too, so there's another one. So the outfield's full again.
Well, maybe Venom was just a stopgap along the way. One thing we do, third baseman Justin Turner is playing very well. Had that knee surgery during the offseason. He went 1-for-3 in last night's game. And this guy's been hot lately, Eric.
Yeah, he's really good for this team because he brings a lot of levity to the team, and he plays hard, and he's not afraid to get dirty and just dive in the dirt. And I had a chance to talk to him because he's the one man band. He's a man for all seasons. He plays every position, and I got a chance to talk to him last week in the dugout.
Well, you know, I came up my whole life playing shortstop, as did a lot of kids.
Yeah.
And then when I got a little bit older, started playing travel ball, I slid over to second base. And once I got into pro ball, you know, I didn't really actually play third base until about a week before I made my major league debut when I was with the Orioles. So kind of had to learn third base on the fly, but I did get a couple seasons down in the Dominican playing winter ball, where I played third base every day down there, and I think that's where I really ended up getting comfortable, you know, playing third base. So at this point in my career, I'm really comfortable playing all three, and or even first base, actually, all four. So it's just fun to move around and take ground balls in different spots.
Is it kind of a double-edged sword? Maybe they're like, well, let's sit Justin because we might want to use him tomorrow at first base, or, you know, about playing time and...
No. I think the more positions you can play, the better off you are. The more opportunities you have to get in the lineup, and when you have guys, you know, like Adrian Gonzalez, who goes out there and plays every day, he's going to need an off day every once in a while. And you know, if you're swinging the bat good and you can play first base, that just opens up another door for you to get in the lineup that day.
You're a local kid, Mayfair High School, Lakewood. Did you grow up in Lakewood, or?
Yeah. I was born in Long Beach. Went to Mayfair High School in Lakewood, and then went down the road to Cal State Fullerton for college.
Is this kind of a dream for you to play for the Dodgers, or did you root for the Dodgers when you were a kid?
Yeah, my whole family was diehard Dodgers fans growing up, so this was really, really special for them. Obviously, very special for myself as well to come back home. You know, my professional career, I think I spent like 8 or 9 years always on the East Coast.
So, sure.
To be able to get out here on the West Coast and be as close to home as I can possibly be, has been real refreshing for me.
And you said you went to Cal State Fullerton. You were drafted by the Reds out of Fullerton. Did you play for George Horton?
Yeah, I had George Horton. I had Dave Serrano was the pitching coach when I was there, and Rick Vanderhook was the assistant. And you know, also other guys, Jason Gill, who's now at Loyola Marymount, was a coach when I was there. Ted Silva was there. He's a pitching coach in Nebraska now. So played for a lot of guys who were all over the country now coaching in college baseball.
You remember your first hit, who it was off of?
In the major leagues?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a funny story, actually. It was on September 11th in New York against the Yankees, Yankee Stadium. So there was a huge, huge tribute, obviously, that night. And it was also the same night that Derek Jeter broke the Yankees hit record.
Wow.
All-time hit record. But as much as I say it was September 11th, we had two, like, hour-and-a-half rain delays and ended up getting in the game. And it was like 1:17 in the morning, so it was actually September 12th, and there was probably 500 fans in the stands who stuck it out, and it was a left-handed pitcher by the name of Michael Dunn that got the first lap.
You still have the ball?
I still have the ball. It's actually at my parents' house. My dad has it up on the mantle.
First home run ball. Do you have that? Do you remember who the first home run was on?
I got to think of his name right now. It was in Houston.
Yeah.
I can't think of the guy's name.
That's all right.
But it was in Houston. It was first and second, nobody out. I thought I was going to be bunting. I think everyone thought I was going to be bunting. And Terry Collins let me swing away. And I think it was a first pitch fastball and hit a 3-run home run.
It's got a tremendously exciting, obvious.
Yeah. It was really cool. You know, I've never been one to hit a ton of homers in my career. And, you know, you hope to run into a few. But that one was pretty cool.
All right, so we got a little bit of background on Justin Turner. In case anybody's, you know, doesn't know who he is, or it goes out to a Dodger game and says, which guy is he? Well, he's usually playing third base, but highly recognizable because he's got this big red beard and this really long red hair, right?
Yeah, he's the free spirit of the Dodgers, and I want to say that he's also the prankster now. But he's a joker, but not a prankster, and he's at every community event. Everybody, if they go to it, they know who he is. And because of that, and his hair and his beard, they decided they were going to have a Justin Turner Chia Night. So in other words, instead of a Chia Pet, it's a Justin Turner Chia. And so they gave it out one night, and you know, you pour water on it, and you grow alfalfa sprouts from the beard and the top of the head.
Yeah.
And I asked them if if that was, you know, if that was his idea and if he had fun with that. Take a listen to that.
The Dodgers came to me this offseason, and Lon Rosen, our marketing guy, said, hey, we have this great idea. We want to do a chia pet for you. And, you know, I kind of chuckled. I didn't know if he was serious or not, but they were serious. And, you know, I said, you know what, go ahead. And, like, I'm all for it. Let's do it. And so they put it together and had a chia night, and it turned out great. I actually had a social media competition to see who could grow the best and the wackiest. And, you know, I got some pretty good responses from it. And I picked, like, 3 or 4 winners and kind of signed some stuff and sent them out to them.
So you can't really, I guess, cut your hair or shave at this point.
I honestly couldn't even tell you the last time I put a razor on my face, so the beard's definitely not going anywhere. And my hair, you know, it gets shortened here and there, but, you know, it always ends up being pretty long by the end.
You're obviously one of the best personalities on the team, and you have a lot of fun. And is it good to be that way for you, or is it?
Yeah. You know, one of the hardest things for me when I was first coming up was figuring out how to balance that having fun, but being a professional and maintaining your work. And when I got to the Mets in 2011 and I got a chance to play with Jose Reyes, you know, he was a guy who loved playing the game, had fun all the time, but was still, you know, mature enough to make sure he got his work in. And, you know, I kind of learned a lot from him. And I also played with Melvin Mora in Baltimore, who was the same way. He had a lot of fun, really enjoyed the game. And Carlos Beltran and David Wright over there. So I had a lot of guys to look up to as a rookie who really set a good example for me on how to enjoy the game on and off the field and be a professional and be a leader and you know when to be serious and know when to you know try to lighten the mood.
And I imagine in a 162 game season, that's you need to have that kind of levity.
Yeah, absolutely. And we have a great clubhouse over here. You know, Adrian Gonzalez is the same way. You know, he loves to joke around and have fun and tell jokes and try to be the funny guy. And you know, he kind of takes the lead in that. And I'm with him all the time. So we kind of come up with these little ideas and stuff to try to have fun. And then, you know, Kike Hernandez is always screwing around.
Sure. Yeah.
We got a good group of young guys that like to have fun and enjoy the game. So it's been awesome.
I want to talk about the young guys. You've got Corey Seager, you've got Trace Thompson. Those guys seem to be kind of stoic and very serious. So they need guys like you, right?
I think on the surface, what everyone sees, you probably think these guys are real quiet and to themselves. But, yeah, you know, when you get them in the clubhouse and behind closed doors, especially the three of those guys, Trace and Corey and Jock, they all live together.
Yeah.
Their relationships kind of are taken to a whole other level because they're around each other so much, and they know how to have fun with each other and press each other's buttons a little bit.
Sure.
So, and I think that is actually, you know, beneficial for our whole team that they have that, because it's kind of carrying over into the clubhouse and on the field with them, and it's spreading out through the locker room. We're getting to know them not only as players, obviously, which they're doing outstanding on the field, but we're getting to know a lot more about them, you know, off the field, which has been a lot of fun.
All right, so that's Justin Turner from Dodger Stadium. His interview with Eric Geller, fun guy, playing well, and it's good. He's coming back from the knee injury. Well, they had a real scare the other night when Kenta Maeda was on the mound at Arizona, and Paul Goldschmidt, a guy who can really crack the ball, almost at home to ruin Kershaw's night last night, hit one right back off the leg of Maeda, The guy makes the play at first base, and then he collapses. Had to be helped off. But the word is he's okay, and he wasn't limping around very much, and he'll be ready to make his next start.
You know, the ball just missed his knee. It just went below the knee. If it hit his knee, he might be out for a while. But he was lucky enough that, or fortunate enough. I don't know if he, well, either way. But you know, it hit the shin bone right there, right below the knee, and I guess it's just a little contusion, and he's fine. The Dodgers are lucky.
Yeah, they can't afford to lose any more pitchers along the way. Angels got a win last night. They beat the Twins 10-2, so they've now won back-to-back games after losing 7 of their last 8. Hector Santiago picked up the win. C.J. Cron and Jeff Bandy each had 3 RBI. And Andrelton Simmons back at short after that thumb injury, so that's good. The Halos will start a 6-game road trip tonight at Oakland. 3 against the A's, 3 against the Astros, and Matt Shoemaker will throw in Friday's game against the last place A's. All right, where do you stand on this one? Ichiro got two hits last night. He's now at 4,257, what puts him one more ahead of Pujols, but almost 1,300 of those hits came in Japan. People are celebrating it. Pete Rose isn't. Where do you stand, Eric Giller?
Look, he didn't have to ever face pitchers like J.R. Richards, Steve Carlton, Nolan Ryan. How about even Don Sutton, players like that?
Yeah,
he's maybe has the international hits record, but there's no way he has the major league hits record. I just think, you know, Pete Rose played the best competition ever, and he still is the hits leader. That's like saying Sada Haruo is your home run champion, is the king of home runs, when he never played in the major leagues.
Yeah, I think the level of competition not nearly up to the speed of Major League Baseball. I think it's a great accomplishment.
Yes.
Ichiro is going to get up to 3,000 hits here soon, and that should be celebrated. But as far as Major League Baseball is concerned, Pete Rose is the all-time hit champ, and until somebody does it in his entire career,
yes,
in Major League Baseball, it's going to stay that way. One bad note in baseball, David Wright, third baseman for the New York Mets, is going to have surgery for a herniated disc in his neck. You could see it watching him play this year. He couldn't make that play to the right on the third baseline. He just didn't get anything on it. He had struggled, and so they're going to try to fix it. They don't know when he's going to be back. All right.
Aaron's there.
Before we get to the break, during the Angels-Indians series last week, Mike Trout hit a shot down to third base that nailed third baseman Juan Uribe right in the cup. Unfortunately for Uribe, he was not wearing a cup. He had to be carted off the field. Now, the good news is he's okay now. But they asked Juan why he did not wear a protective cup, and he had one of the best answers I've ever heard. He said, and I'm quoting here, "I don't think the trainers have my size."
He wins. That's awesome.
Come on, Open Season, you're going to hear from L.A. Rams quarterback Jared Goff. And up next, I'll chat with Texans defensive lineman Devin Still. He's going to be celebrating his daughter's victory over cancer this Father's Day and his new job playing alongside J.J. Watt and Vince Wilfork in Houston.
J.J., you win 2 Defensive Player of the Year, and you don't try to learn from that, man. Something's wrong. Vince, this is his 13th year in the league, so he's seen everything. So you can really pick his brain about certain situations and how you handle it.
Have you ever gone to use a flashlight and the batteries were dead or the inside of the flashlight corroded, only having to throw it away? Or in a location where you had no way to charge your cell phone or camera? Well, all that has changed. Now there's Hybrid Light. The Hybrid Light brings the best of both worlds together with a strong 160 lumen LED light that lasts 12 hours on a single charge. And after a recharge from any light or power source, you're ready to go again. Hybrid Light lasts 7 long years and is even waterproof, and also contains a USB port to plug in your cell phone or camera to give you that special charge when you're not near an outlet. All this for the low price of $39.95 with promo code GARY. Call 1-800-297-8109 and be the first to have this great tool, or go to our website, hybridlight.com. That's 800-297-8109 or hybridlight.com, HYBRIDLIGHT.com. And don't forget to use promo code GARY.
If you're trying to prevent a home foreclosure, you need the Goodman Law Firm on your side. Goodman has a nationwide network of foreclosure attorneys to represent you during the mortgage mitigation process. The Goodman Firm has resolved troubled mortgages across the nation. Take control of your mortgage situation today. Call the Goodman Law Firm, 888-800-6030, or contact them online at www.arnoldgoodmanlaw.com.
Larry Burnett back with you here on Open Season. And since we've got Father's Day coming up, we thought we'd look for a good feel-good story. And we found one down in Houston, Texas. That's where Devin Still is playing for the Houston Texans. And you probably remember Dev from his days with the Cincinnati Bengals. And it was back in 2014 that his daughter Leah was diagnosed with cancer and went through surgery and so on and so forth. Devin is joining us now from Houston. And first, let's give the folks listening an update on how Leah is doing. How is she?
She's doing wonderful. She finished up treatment a couple of months ago, so she's getting back to just being a normal kid. Actually, next week she graduates from kindergarten, so things are really starting to go in a positive direction.
I mentioned Father's Day. It has to be right. That much more special for Devin Still than just about any other dad in the world, I would think.
It is, because with my daughter battling cancer, I had a chance of losing my daughter, but she was strong and she continued to fight. And this will actually be our first Father's Day with her out of the hospital, so I'm definitely looking forward to spending some time with her.
Yeah. Did that fight make you stronger too, Devin?
It definitely did. I think anybody who goes through that type of battle, it makes you stronger because it allows you to see what life is all about, and it allows you to cherish every moment that you have with your loved ones, because at any second, it could be gone. I mean, it was a scary 2 years.
Yeah.
When she first got diagnosed, we tried a treatment that ultimately didn't work. And I think at that moment, we were scared that we was going to lose my daughter. But we found a different treatment that put her into remission. But while she was going through her stem cell transplant, she developed VOD, which is basically the chemo was so high that it made the veins in her liver enlarge, which put her life at risk then. But she continued to fight like she always does, and she made it through that also.
Talking with Devin Still, who's now a defensive lineman for the Houston Texans. As a dad myself, I can take a lot of stuff, and certainly you get beat up on the football field and whatever, but there's not a whole lot of pain that's worse than when something happens to your kid, is there?
Right. I mean, especially in this type of situation, because, when you try to compare football to battling cancer, there's really no comparison.
Yeah.
Because we're not fighting for our life on the football field. We're fighting for a job. But, as a parent, to watch it, cancer is hard because you're really limited to what you can do for the child besides be there and comfort them through the fight. The fight is really on them to continue to fight whenever the times get rough.
Yeah, I think through it all, I think the country was certainly taken by Leah's maturity, if you will, her ability to overcome adversity at her very young age. You talk about her getting back to being normal. What does that mean now for her and for you?
Just going back to school, which she missed out on when she was diagnosed. She was in preschool when she was diagnosed. So just being able to be around other kids, go outside and enjoy the playground, learn how to ride bikes or go swimming, or all things that she had to put on hold while she was battling cancer. So to see her get back to that, it's definitely a blessing for me and my family.
Yeah, no question about it. Talking with Devin Still, he's down in Houston, Texas, and he's doing some work for Dove Men Plus Care, delivering daddy care packages as part of their My Dad, My Hero program. And you're trying to help out some new dads, right?
I am. As you stated, Father's Day is coming up, so I'm partnering with Dove Men Plus Care to celebrate how dads' care and size really elevate them to hero status in the eyes of their children.
And these little care packages you're giving out, what's in them, and what advice do you have for new dads?
In the package is a variety of grooming products that we're going to be giving them. We just want to make sure that they have everything they need to be successful from the very beginning. We're also giving them a letter welcoming them to fatherhood. And what I think is the most important is a birth cloth. I know, because when I was first became a dad with Leah, the first experience with birth of the baby after having that bottle, it can get pretty ugly if you don't know what you're doing. So we want to make sure they're protected.
Oh, yeah, that's a good lesson learned right there. Hey, how endearing was it for you, Devin, to see the outpouring of concern when Leah was diagnosed and when she was in the hospital? Because I know so many people stepped up, and the Bengals stepped up, and they sold jerseys, mm-hmm. and they donated money. How cool was that for you?
I mean, we needed that. as I stated before, you know, fighting pediatric cancer, it's tough on the family. But when you see you have so many people rooting for you, those times that it get hard and you want to give up, you know you can't give up because there's so many people behind you pushing you to see you beat this disease. And I think just having that for my family, it helped push us through those dark times.
Were there times during the past couple of years when you felt like giving up?
It was a lot of times that I wanted to give up. But as I said, the amount of people we had behind us wouldn't allow me. You know, My wife was out there with me. She continued to push me at times, you know, where I didn't think I can continue to go on. You know, just seeing that my daughter had the attitude that no matter what she was going through, she wasn't going to give up because we needed her. You know, it really influenced me to continue to go on.
And one of the byproducts of everything that you and Leah went through is that you actually put off your wedding for a couple of years, right? You just got married recently.
Right. Yeah, I did. And when Leah was diagnosed, me and my wife, we got engaged because I had an understanding of how hard that role was going to be for us.
Yeah.
And I knew that I had to give everything to my daughter as far as mentally. So I had to take away from my fiance at the time. And I thought that giving her a ring would allow her to know that, you know, she always had my heart, no matter what I was going through mentally. And because we wanted Leah to be our flower girl, we decided to hold off the wedding until she was able to beat cancer because we wanted her to walk down the aisle healthy.
That had to be a very special day.
It was. It definitely was.
All right, now you're with the Houston Texans. You've been away from football for a little bit. And quite frankly, Dev, you know, for a while there, Leah was the star of the family. Is it time for Dad to be the star again?
Oh, yeah. It's time to focus back on football. You know, I'm blessed with an amazing opportunity, you know. I dedicated myself for the past 2 years to my daughter, and now that she's beat cancer, I was given another opportunity at my dream of playing in the NFL. And with the Texans, I have a wonderful opportunity to play for them as long as I come down here and show my ability and show what I'm capable of doing. I think that this is going to be a totally different year than the previous years.
Okay, you join a defensive line down there that has a guy by the name of J.J. Watt and a pretty good veteran by the name of Vince Wilfork as well. Have you been able to pick their brains any? Have you been able to learn from these guys?
I stay in their back pocket. Just as far as J.J., you win two defensive player of the year and you don't try to learn from that man, something's wrong. Vince, this is his 13th year in the league, so he's seen everything. So you can really pick his brain about certain situations and how you handle it. And, you know, they've been a real big help for me because being away from the game for a year, it definitely has its disadvantages. But being around those guys really caught me back up to speed.
Talking with Devin Still, defensive lineman for the Houston Texans. And I understand as well that you and Leah actually had some kind of a relationship with J.J. even before you hooked up with the Texans, correct?
We did. We had a chance to meet him. The NFL honors, and this is when I had just signed with the Texans. So my daughter had a chance to meet J.J., and he welcomed her to Texas. And I don't know what else he said to her, but she fell in love with him because actually on the ride back to the hotel, she sat with him on the bus instead of me, and that never happened. So I don't know what type of relationship they got going on.
Oh, he's got that magnetism, I guess, is what it is. What do you feel that you have to do this year to be a contributor to the Texans?
Play my football. You know, the same dedication that I gave to my daughter these past 2 years, give that same dedication to the game of football, and I think everything would turn out the right way.
A lot of people look at your team and they say quarterback is going to be a key position. The acquisition was made during the offseason of Osweiler. From what you've seen and what you know, can he be the answer for the Houston Texans at that position?
Well, I think so. I think the Texans went out and got him because they see something special in him. They think he can help out the team. As far as me being on the defense, I really can't, you know, judge Brock on what he's doing because that's not my specialty. But I think that he really brings that fire to the team that we need just from being around him these past couple of weeks.
I really appreciate your time. I appreciate your work with the Dove Men Plus Care and the Dad Care packages down there in the Houston area. And I wish you a very happy, happy Father's Day and the best of health to your daughter, Leah. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
All right, that's Devin Still, who is now with the Houston Texans. And if anybody deserves to enjoy a good Father's Day this weekend, it's Devin. He and his family have been through hell with Leah's situation. The good news is she had surgery. They did stem cell transfers. She went into remission, and now she is, for all intents and purposes, cancer-free. Can't get any better than that. Coming up in a little bit, we're going to talk. You'll get to hear with Jared Goff, quarterback of the LA Rams, talking about as they get towards the end of OTAs. And how about this story heading to break? Cowboys running back Darren Fitzpatrick is going to miss months. He dropped his cell phone while he was at home, and he broke his elbow when he dove and tried to keep the phone from getting moved. This guy hasn't had enough injury problems throughout his career. Now, out months. Cell phone.
I'm thinking.
Open season and coming up, the old boss is back for the Anaheim Ducks. Oakmont is officially open for the U.S. Open, but it's awfully wet. And Jared Goff is feeling pretty good as OTAs wind down for the L.A. Rams.
Started to slow down. At first, it was fast, and then you get more comfortable and you see stuff more often. You see the looks a few more times, and it starts to slow down a little bit. So I feel pretty good about it.
If you're trying to prevent a home foreclosure, you need the Goodman Law Firm on your side. Goodman has a nationwide network of foreclosure attorneys to represent you during the mortgage mitigation process. The Goodman Firm has resolved troubled mortgages across the nation. Take control of your mortgage situation today. Call the Goodman Law Firm, 888-800-6030, or contact them online at www.arnoldgoodmanlaw.com.
9MD Beverly Hills provides skincare solutions for patients undergoing cancer treatments. Personalized treatment regimens are initiated to achieve optimum remission states in those dealing with cancer. The IS Clinical Harmony Cancer Care Facial at 9MD Beverly Hills safely offers hope and relief for those challenged with the side effects and repercussions of intense cancer treatments such as radiation and chemotherapy. Rejuvenate, replenish, and soothe your skin. Let our certified technicians at 9MD Beverly Hills safely and effectively heal your skin with our IS Clinical products that are pharmaceutical grade, botanically based, paraben free, and do not enter the bloodstream. Enjoy a day of pampering and revitalize your skin with 9MD Beverly Hills and our IS Clinical Harmony Cancer Care Facial for just $179. Each patient will receive a complimentary gift bag for take-home care. For more information, please call 310-777-7511 or visit us at www.9amd.com. That's www.9amd.com.
Hey, it's time for more fun and games here on Open Season. Glad to have you with us. I'm Larry Burnett along with Eric Geller. Talking some more NFL now. The Rams wrapping up their OTAs in Oxnard this week. And as expected, first-round pick Jared Goff has moved in to take snaps with the first-team offense this week. The quarterback out of Cal, well, he's put in the time, he's put in the work, and he says it's all paying off on the field.
Half of it. I think the first half of it was a lot of learning, a lot of thinking. And then I think, you know, halfway through last week, started to become more playing and more just feeling natural and feeling, you know, more comfortable every day, getting more comfortable. And now through 8 practices, it's feel fairly comfortable and pretty, you know, excited about continuing to make those steps and continue to feel more comfortable and all that. But, yeah, I think just overall I feel, you know, 100 times more comfortable and ready than I was at the beginning.
Yeah, Eric, you've been out at the OTAs quite a bit while the Rams have been going through their workouts and things. You've seen Jared Goff as he's progressed. How much has he progressed?
He's progressed very well. Last week he had some issues because it was he was having problems with some of the plays, but apparently something clicked for him. And he says, like you said in that earlier soundbite, everything has started to slow down for him. going up against that number one defense of the Rams, which is a top 10 defense in the NFL. He looks really good. His foot movement looks good. Coach Fisher's extremely happy with the way he's progressed. And also there's Sean Mannion that's playing well as well. So he looks really good, and he made some incredible throws the other day. There was one throw to rookie Michael Thomas, I think it's Southern Mississippi, and he got him in the corner of the end zone all by himself, and he laid it right in his hands, and he dropped it, and everybody in camp went, oh, it was incredible. But he's playing very well. Goff is he's starting to get it going, and I think all of this, you know, he's signed and he's had the playbook from the moment that he stepped in and was introduced to the media. I think it'll benefit him, and he'll be the starter come that Monday night game in Santa Clara against the 49ers. He looks really good.
Right, and as you said, he's been working against the Rams' first-team defense, and they are one of the best in the NFL. And they've thrown a lot of different looks at the kid, and the rookie's done well, and Goff has responded. Listen to the quarterback.
There's, you know, the first-team defense out there, and they're, you know, one of the best defenses in the league, so it's definitely a little bit different. They do so much stuff over there, and they do it well, so it's definitely, you know, different for us and me as a rookie seeing so many looks right now. But I think, like I said, in the long run, I think it's going to be very beneficial and something I'm going to look back on and be like, wow, I'm thankful I saw all that, you know, early on and am able to recognize it now.
It's got to be kind of daunting to come right out of college and then go against these multiple pro defenses that the teams like the Rams use, and they're very good at. They throw a lot of different looks at the kid. But it does seem to pay off in the long run. And when he gets against live competition in the fall, I think it's going to pay off there as well. Now, they break camp, they break OTAs, and then they've got like a month off before they go down to UC Irvine?
Yeah, it's about, I'd say about a month, 5 weeks. And I know Jared said that he's going to be staying down this way with a lot of the other players because, well, they want to move down here because the weather's great. So they're all going to look, especially the wide receivers, they're all going to sit down and just study by themselves with the playbook. So meanwhile, the Rams are moving their whole operation down to UC Irvine. So that's, I think it's the last week of July, yeah, or maybe the middle of July that they're in camp. So he's going up for a couple of days to hang out with his parents and his family, but then he's coming right back down here with all the wide receivers.
Yeah, so they'll have a month, 5 weeks off, but as you heard Eric say, I know Case Keenum's going to come back, Goff's going to come back, they'll bring some of the wide receivers back, and they'll go over the playbook, they'll throw the ball around,
sure,
they'll get used to each other, and they'll, you know, hopefully get on the same page in the process. In case you're wondering, though, Goff has not spent all of his time with the Rams focusing on football. Oh, no. He has kept tabs on his Golden State Warriors in the NBA Finals, and he likes their chances in Cleveland tonight.
I think they'll be all right with Draymond Thursday night. We'll be all right. No worries. I don't get too worried when they lose because they don't lose two in a row very often.
We will see. Game 6 coming up shortly from Cleveland with Golden State leading that series 3-2. In between shows, the Penguins beat San Jose to win the Stanley Cup championship. Nice for Sidney Crosby. Nice for a team that struggled early in the year and changed coaches and showed that you could pull it all together before Christmas time and end up with a cup when you get to June.
They did what the Kings did a few years back when when the Kings fired Andy Murray in December, and they brought in Daryl Sutter, and they went on to win the Stanley Cup. Yeah, they played extremely well, the Penguins, and it was fun to watch. If you love hockey, and, you know, we love hockey, so it was fun to watch those guys. And it's still amazing to me that Sidney Crosby, it's only his second Stanley Cup.
Yeah.
He's been around for 11 years.
Yeah, I think he thought he was going to have a lot more by now. That team has got some quickness. They've got some speed. They had a hot goaltender. Yeah. And you put all that together, and it turned into a Stanley Cup. Also news from the NHL this week, and it's apparently unofficial, at least at this point, but it looks like the National Hockey League is going to put an expansion team in Las Vegas, like 2017, maybe.
I'm surprised they didn't go for a minor league team first, but that's such a beautiful building. What are they going to be called? Are they going to be called the Strippers, the Gamblers? What are they going to be called? I think it's great, though.
I think they'll be the Las Vegas Sinners is what they'll be.
I think it's great for the NHL.
That covers a multitude of things. Yeah.
The whole thing, yeah. I think it's great for the NHL because they're always struggling to get viewership, and I think, you know, getting people to Las Vegas will – will kind of spark a lot of people to watch the NHL, I think. I think that'll help a little bit.
Yeah, I see. I'm not sure it's going to work. I'm not sure that people want to go to Las Vegas to watch hockey. I'm not sure people from Buffalo in February want to go to Las Vegas to go inside and be next to the ice. I hope it works, because that would probably open the door. For, you know, maybe the Raiders, the NFL goes in. Maybe it becomes
a
big pro city. But, you know, I don't know. If you don't have that fan base that's right there to carry you, I don't know that you can count on the people coming from Nebraska in March and saying, oh, yeah, well, let's go into an igloo and watch hockey, you know? So I don't know.
That's why, to me, I consider Las Vegas a minor league city. They have a minor league baseball affiliate. You know, it's just another novelty, another piece of entertainment you can go to. But I don't think people want to spend $150 a ticket to go, you know, watch an NHL team play if they don't care about the NHL, you know. So, but, you know, people will be curious on TV in other parts of the country. So I might get more viewership that way for the network.
Yeah, I'm just figuring out, you know, okay, I got a hockey ticket or I got strippers. You know, what am I going to do?
Or the World Series of Poker. Which one? You know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's a whole joke, a whole other joke there somewhere. Anze Kopitar is going to be the new team captain for the LA Kings next season.
Good choice.
And sorry and sad to report, happened while we were away, Gordie Howe passed away. Mr. Hockey, I mean, one of the all-time greats of the sport, played until he was in his 50s and was still playing strong. I mean, he's one of the all-time classic greats.
I just remember him playing when he played with the WHA, I think, towards the end of his career. And it was just, I never got to see him at his best, but just to be able to say, I met him a couple times, which was an honor. But I'm sorry that I never really got to see him play, but you can go to YouTube, and that's the beauty of YouTube now. And yeah, he's one of the royalty. He's, if you're talking about a Mount Rushmore of hockey, he's up there, so... It's definitely hockey royalty. And
yeah, absolutely is. Mr. Hockey. And by the way, the U.S. Open Golf got underway today. They had a bunch of rain delays. Never even got the first round done. I mean, it was just pouring out there at Oakmont as they tried to get the round one in. But when 17 holes done, Andrew Landry has a one-stroke lead over Bubba Watson, and it was pouring out there. So I don't even know if they'll get to play tomorrow. But we'll have to wait and see. And I was watching the... Northern Ireland-Ukraine hockey game today. I had it on when I was working on the show, and they stopped the game because of hail. They had big old hail coming down, and the commentators were saying, wait a minute, they played in snow before, why are they stopping the game?
Really?
You guys are getting stuck with hail.
Don't they have helmets they anyway? That'll help. Yeah. Where are the helmets? Keep playing.
Anyway, next week we'll be back. We'll be talking about the NBA draft. Lots to talk about. Thanks, Eric, for being with us. Di Rice, thanks for your help. Jared Goff, Justin Turner, Devin Still, all part of our show today. And happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. Be sure to join us next week on Open Season. As I said, we'll be talking about the draft and a whole lot more. So we will see you next Thursday, 3:05 p.m., Open Season, right here on KCAA. Until then, try to get out and have some fun.
Are you having any fun? What you getting out of living? What good is what you've got if you're not having any fun? Are you having any laughs? Are you getting any love? If other people do so, can you have a little fun?
You're listening to KCAA. Loma Linda, California.
NBC Radio. Despite intense efforts by the soda industry to block its passage, Philadelphia has become the first major U.S. city to approve a soda tax. 1.5 cents for every ounce of sugary, even diet sodas that are sold in the city. On Wall Street, stocks began today's session sharply lower on investor worries about the so-called Brexit. That's next week's vote in Britain over whether to exit the European Union. But with a final hour buying spree, the Dow 93 points higher today, the Nasdaq up 10. Solid earnings after the bell from Oracle, with its cloud computing operations offsetting weakness in its software business. Gunmaker Smith & Wesson easily topped earnings forecast last quarter, and despite a spate of gun violence over the past week, it's predicting a rise in sales because of efforts to tighten up gun control measures. And cosmetics giant Revlon buying perfume maker Elizabeth Arden. Tom Busby, CNBC.
That power drill you bought in 96 is working about as awesome as a 20-year-old drill should, meaning not so awesome. So trade it in at Napa and get a $25 instant rebate toward a new DeWalt cordless drill kit. There's only one word to describe instantly getting $25 off a new DeWalt drill, and that word is awesome. That's Napa know-how. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores while supplies last. Trade-in rebate may vary. Offer expires 6/30/16.
If you have hard water, the limescale not only leaves white spots, it clogs pipes and breaks down appliances, costing you hundreds of dollars in energy and wear. Eliminate limescale and other water issues like brown staining, bad odors, and lead with HydroCare water products available from Wave Home Solutions. Wave's affordable systems don't use salts or chemicals. You'll love the way your water tastes, smells, and looks. Satisfaction guaranteed. For more information, go to goodclearwater.com. That's goodclearwater.com.
Good afternoon. It is 4:02. I'm Di Rice with the very latest in live, local, and national news here on KCAA, 1050 AM and 106.5 FM. GOP House Speaker Paul Ryan won't say whether he would support legislation preventing people on the federal terror watch list from being able to buy guns.
We do not take away a citizen's rights without their due process. If you have a quick idea in the heat of a moment that says, let's take away a person's rights without their due process, we're going to stand up and defend the Constitution.
Ryan was pressed about gun violence after the massacre at a gay nightclub in Orlando. He said that Congress must get it right. Ryan also said the U.S. must do a better job of preventing acts of homegrown terrorism. The speaker argued that the congressional actions must not get in the way of legitimate terror investigations. And here at home, work on the 2016-17 county budgets is nearing completion. Riverside County supervisors open public hearings on Monday on a spending plan that exceeds this year's $5.3 billion in appropriations. Discretionary revenues peaked 10 years ago, and many departments have sacrificed to maintain essential service levels. A final budget will not be adopted until September. Meantime, San Bernardino County supervisors are primed to adopt their budget June 28th. Ramped up security in the wake of last December's terrorist attack at the IRC will cost $10.2 million, plus $2 million in security assessments at all county buildings. The county has built up $407 million in reserves. And the Palm Springs International Short Fest and Short Film Market opens Tuesday. Now in its 22nd year, the Short Fest will showcase 328 short films from 54 countries. The concurrent short film market will feature a library of more than 4,100 short films available to film buyers, industry, and press. The only short film market in North America. And the Short Fest runs through June 27th and again begins next Tuesday. Inland Empire weather. It is going to be mostly sunny tomorrow, high of 87. By Saturday, we're warming up to about 94. 106 by Sunday, Father's Day, and even warmer than that on Monday, up to about 110. Checking out your drive. It is 83 degrees. By the way, here in San Bernardino, checking out your drive, there is a disabled vehicle blocking the center lane of the 10 eastbound right at Euclid Avenue. Through Ontario, an accident has cleared eastbound side of the 10 at Etiwanda, but traffic is still very slow in pockets from the 57. Through Corona, stop and go 15 northbound between Magnolia Avenue and the 91 freeway. The southbound 15 is slow and go from the 10 to Cahalco. Fontana, stop and go traffic 15 northbound between Sierra all the way up to Cleghorn into that pass. It's kind of looks like a Friday if you look at the traffic going through there now, but it is just a Thursday. Merino Valley, stop and go 215 between Cactus Avenue and Alessandro.
And the southbound side is slow from Mount Vernon to Central, and then once again from Cactus to Van Buren. 60 East, stop and go, Valley Way to the 215. Tom Hartman on the way right here at the station that leaves no listener behind. KCAA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM.
This is the Tom Hartman Program.
Idea's parents, Nate and Cleo, are in this chamber tonight, along with more than two dozen Americans whose lives have been torn apart by gun violence. They deserve a vote. They deserve a vote. They deserve a vote.